to send our visas off, and then we're going to go and look for a lake.
It's
about
so
it.
Simple.
Yeah. So, yeah, been greeted by some cows this morning.
Situation with the visas. Right, basically, when we planned to come here, we thought, right, we can stay here as long as we want, because it's the EU. But because of the visas, we've got a 90-day visa, but we can only stay here 30 days at a time, which means we have to leave Turkey every 30 days and come back in with a fresh stamp. But if we're sending away for visas that can take 4 to 6 weeks to process, how are we meant to send away and leave the country and come back in without the passports? So we've got this huge predicament.
Hey, donkey.
Anyway, I'm going to feed this cow this whole cabbage.
Go on, take it. Take it.
Wolfing it down. It's all the way, that's Greek cabbage, that. Or lettuce, even. Donkey, you look like you're going to buck me or something. The donkey's buck. They do, didn't it? Buckaroo, that was a donkey, wasn't he? And, we have here the wild man. Just been to the first cash point in Turkey, expecting to see euros, and then I've seen this. Turkish lira, so that there is worth about 35 quid, 100 lira, 35 quid, so that's the limit, the maximum per week to be able to spend.
Oh.
20, thank you sir. So yeah, so Turkish lira, no more euros, so you did me a favour by bailing me having to bail you out on the border by getting rid of my euros. Alright, let's go in this post office and buy an envelope. Yeah, it's pretty strange here. Like there's three SIM card shops: Turkcell, TTNet, and Vodafone. Nights he goes into Turkcell. Big debate happens between like six people. Blah, 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 blah. Comes out, points over there. Right, go to that shop. Okay, sound. Goes into there. We look on the window. There's 3G available for 19 euros or something like that. You know, plus the SIM card costs. In there, they were being called into the next shop with the Vodafone site. Like, oh my god, it's worse. I don't know. I don't think they're like English people or they're uneducated about English people. But, we looked up yesterday about the visa thing, and we seem to be the only country out of the EU that has to pay for a visa. They're like allowance, you know, letting Bulgarians, Italians, French, all of them lot in for free. All right, and then this is the bigger joke as well. Russians get a 60-day visa. We only get 30 days. It's like, how mental is that? And in the post office as well. She's going Iceland because we put Jersey Channel Islands. She's gone Jersey Channel Iceland. No. Show her on the map. Where is this? United Kingdom, England. No, don't have a clue. Blah, blah, blah. Just don't have a clue who England is, and they don't want to know, so I don't know what it is, but we've obviously pissed them off somewhere down the line. I'm sure we'll be sound, but on a plus side, the people here are friendly, you know, they see you, they're like, hello, speaking English, hello, you know, where's the post office? We had about 20 people direct to the post office, they were like, all happy to like, come on, I will take you. Me? Come here. As I'm talking about. Anyway, I'm wanted in the shop. Could be a cup of tea on the go here. So following on from my last vids, I now have a Turkish coffee in my hand. And Nightsy's been invited for a smoke. This is our new friend here, Alid.
That's nice, mate.
Is it nice, is it? I haven't tried it. I was burning my fingers when I was lifting the glass. So this is him, this is Alid. This is our Vodafone contact. And you? Yeah. Say hello.
Hello.
So yeah, so we're in Turkey, we're meeting good people already. And Nightsy said this is great, so I'm gonna try it now, so I'm gonna put the phone away. So this is Nightsy trying to get his bike up a step. Oi, there's a winch system up there, mate. Look. Oh, you got help that time. You just flipped it before, like.
Oh, I've got to fuck, you're getting rid of this weight.
Cool, so a further setback is we're on the visa site today and they now only accept passport photos that are 2 inch by 2 inch, and obviously we got, when we revised all this was last year, and we got the smaller ones, so we've asked the guy at the internet cafe where can get a photo, he's brought us here, and this guy's he's done the job, but I now have a classic bob. Quite a good haircut. I might go and get it shaped up properly, innit? And stick with it. Devilishly handsome bloke that is.
I've managed to pick up a couple of pets. I don't know why, but they're just following me. They're not barking or chasing me. They're just following. If I stop, they just stand by me. So there you go. A couple of pets for Turkey. Whatever.
Mission. Absolute mission. So we thought, right, after lunch we'll go to Kesan, sort the SIM cards, and then find somewhere to pitch. So got to Kesan. Massive detour. Some guy, where's Kesan? This way. Okay, sounds. Looked at the time, 6:30. So, right, okay, we may as well just go down here, which looked like fields and stuff like that, and pitch up, and then we'll go in the morning. So we went down there, went down these fields, and next minute these pickup trucks with a couple of sets of guys in stopped. What are you doing? Just going down here. Nah. That way, go to the crossroads, signalling the cross where their thing is. Crossroads. Right, okay, sound, backtrack. Everyone's a bit funny there. Couldn't find anywhere to stay, so we went down the next track, going along, mental, big-ass dogs, angry dogs chasing us and jumping up on the bikes and that, and then, yeah, it's absolutely lashing down at the same time, might I add, and then mud flicking up everywhere, going along the track, thinking, yeah, Sam might actually get somewhere here. Next minute, all these Turk gypos standing there, where are you going? This way, can't go that way, why not? Dogs will bark, got to go that way. We just said Kesan, yeah, left, went up this massive left, and then just the same shit over and over and over. So we've had to come all the way back out of the city, and then we finally found this place, but everything's absolutely soaked and we haven't really achieved anything, so we'd have been better off staying in Ipsala and then packing up and coming in tomorrow rather than going through two thunderstorms and getting nowhere. So yeah, but anyway, gonna start getting some food on the go because I'm pretty hungry, and it's gone 7:30 now, I think. So, just one of those days. Any input, Nods? Don't even start on me, boy.
My books are only just dried from the last time.
I'll get a couple of them, man. How's the stomach going?
Feels like I need a fat shit. You know what I mean? But I've already been for one, so.
Nothing to poo out.
Later and have a
Gaviscon. A what? Gaviscon. Oh, Gaviscon. Instead of Gaviskin, I was like, oh, sounds new. Anyway, yeah, so, yeah, whatever. We're going to dry up and cook up and sleep.
Cook up.
To you. Oh, I'll wait for Pakistan for that. Anyway, yeah, ciao for now. Right, so we're no longer tent bound. The, weather has just decided to sort itself out now, you know. It's been raining the last couple of days, and I sort of prayed for a bit of sun this morning so I could actually dry my stuff, and then I'm still minging, so I thought, right, pack it away, packed everything away, and then bang, sun's out, and it's getting really hot again. So we're back to nice weather. Nightsies Paneer. Don't know how many videos we've had about this Paneer now, but this is close to the final one. You can see there, it's gone basically. No need for an explanation, just it's gone and that's it. So yeah, he's going to need to sort it out. So the plan is, I've forgotten the town, but we were going to go back to Ipsala because it's quite cool there, but we thought, you know what, we'll just go to the next town that way because it doesn't really matter what we're doing, you know, we're just waiting. And so we're going to go there and we're going to charge up because tonight is the Champions League final, which we want to either stream and streaming a tent in the middle of a field, which is crazy. It sounds crazy, but that's what we do. Or watching a cafe. But if we're watching a cafe, then we need to find somewhere with where we can lock the stuff up and that. So maybe finding a mosque and asking the whatever they're called, the Islamic priests, if we can use their teaching rooms or whatever, you know, and stay in there and get a wash, because we're actually up to, and it's sickening to say, day 10 without a wash or change of clothes. Although I have alternated my pants and my shorts, so now I'm just in my shorts now. But this is the last stretch for what I'm wearing. And I feel sorry for the people in Turkcell yesterday, because I sat in there for about half an hour and I must have absolutely stank. But yeah, so anyway, we don't really care about stinking, if I'm honest. I'm rambling now, so I'm gonna go. So, bye bye.
Nereye gidiyormuşum
galiba? Right.
Abi, we just come and get some oil. Didn't give me some teas.
Eating there, then
had some photos taken.
So oil, teas, and photos sitting in the sun. These are our mechanical engineers, shall we say?
I am music schools. Music school.
Musical. Musical genius.
Music school.
Music school.
Ah,
right. Okay.
Music school.
Good stuff, man. Alright.
Serkan çağırdı. Enstrümantalist Serkan çağırdı. Üstü şenlendirici.
Piano, guitar. Ha.
So he played piano, and I played a bass guitar, you know? That's it.
Serkan çağırdı is famous.
This is the chai boy.
Famous enstrümantalist.
He's the man with the T's, but he's not really sure what's going on. I think he's too young with the language barrier. Anyway, but these are our peeps here. And they all sound like.
I am speaking.
Cool, so we're still here. We're learning Turkish, and we've been directed to a hotel, which is like $15 each max. A bike shop to get a new paneer, which is 20-30 Turkish lira max, so that's about a tenner. And asked them where I can get a Turkish football shirt, and they said on the bazaar, and it will cost me 10 Turkish lira, so like 3-4 quid, which is just a bargain. So our mission is to maybe have another chai and then go north and then find all these places that we're going to. So yeah, so that's the plan for today. So where are we, Shaggy?
We're in the Chetan Hotel number 2.
Number 1.
Number 1.
Yeah, the luxury, mate.
The posh one over there. We've got the damp covered wall one. It's the south. We've only paid 9 quid.
With the chipped leaking bottom. Oh, it's a shower. The floor's the shower. It's a wet room. It's a wet room. But up there looks pretty good, doesn't it? Yeah, wait to see some fucking cockroaches. But oh, look, complimentary slippers, mate. Ah, oh, yes, and bars of soap and towels. Great bargain, man. So how much should we barter for this? So it was 60 originally. Done. He was being quite stern on that. I said 40. No, 60. 45. No, 60. One person, 30. Two people, 60. I went 25, 25, 50. Right. That's how it sounded.
Not bad, mate.
Not bad.
But yeah, like you just said, though, this probably is going to be our last hotel for a little while. Thing is, we have to send our passports off for the visas, and they wanted our passport downstairs, so...
Wouldn't accept a copy.
No, wouldn't accept an email. So, yeah, I'm going to enjoy my last sleep.
The final hotel, and it's luxurious. It's beautiful.
Oh, my God.
Right, time to clean up 10 days' worth of crap. Aye. Let's have a look at your feet. Soggy and minging. Get them windows open. Right, for now.
Ciao.
Little stroll around Turkey Town, and we're definitely getting some looks. Don't know why. Wouldn't know why anyone would be staring at us, but anyway, we're just going around. There's some, you know, strange music going on that's blasted down the town. And, yeah,
it's different, isn't it?
Yeah, it's cool though. I like it. Yeah. It doesn't feel like threatening or anything. It feels nice and relaxed. So, yeah. Anything to add?
Really?
Not really.
Still feel like shite.
Nicely feels like shite, so he's going to... what was that place called? Eznak? Pharmacy.
Pharmacy?
Yeah.
See all the local delicacies
and pharmacy. Yeah. I might get a cup of tea, mate. Nice coffee. Anyway, whatever.
Enjoying that, you fat bastard.
That's a big slab of it for like 30p. Just bought 1,000 grams of Bickies for 70p. So for quid. Could put on a bit of weight. Good, isn't it? Well, this place is just mental, man. Isn't it?
The market is pretty chaotic. Like, watch out for fucking...
Oh, picky puppies.
Horse-drawn carts and shit about on the road now. People shouting left, right, and center. It's a proper bizarre, so. Good though.
Good stuff, man. So, what have we got here? Mate, that looks and smells so good. Yogurt as well. I don't know how much this is. This looks quality, mate. What do I do? Bang that in with it? They drink it with it. It's a good job. I'm glad he's doing it because I would have started just slapping it over there, though.
Jersey's lady, door to service.
Hello?
It's
locked.
It's in the door.
Oh no, it's not. It's there, look. Who was it? Turn it up, mate. Yeah. Hey!
Yeah.
Fuck you. Right, for all you that didn't know or doesn't know Nightsy's occupation, he's an electrician. And whenever he seems to go in a gaff, he plays with light fittings. It's like a little, what's it? A hobby.
A hobby, yeah.
There you go. And then, so, what's the crack with this one?
I didn't know what this was, so I thought I'd come and have a look, yeah. You've got like. Green.
Yeah.
Screwing light.
Bang that up there, man, that'd be fine. Look at that. Hello?
Volume down, Yvette.
Hello? What an idiot. So yeah, so what's the crack with that light?
As I was saying before, we were rudely interrupted. It's only fucking 1 o'clock, you know what I mean?
On a Saturday.
This is sort of job that I do.
You're just sticking your fingers in it, mate. Is it done with stereo wire?
No, that's what I do to a car Saturday. Light
thing. I don't even know where the fucking switch for it is.
Dodgy. The TV don't work either. I don't know what that's about.
TV don't work. Over here, just here, is stinking of dampness. Go on, pick some wallpaper up. Is he still knocking on the wall?
Oh, mate.
It's minging, isn't it?
It's just like... May as well not be there.
Yeah.
It'll just be concrete.
Yeah, just have plain walls.
Look at that, it's going to fall down up there, right?
And look at the state of the towels they give you.
So I went for a shower before, yeah. Fucking, I mean, he comes out, big towel and that, so I just picked what I thought was mine up, you know, there are two beds in here. It's a fucking floor towel. Look at this.
Doesn't even go all the way around.
He comes out looking like fucking Tarzan.
Fucking unbelievable, though.
Oh.
But I suppose nine quid,
isn't it? Nine quid, mate, yeah. It's a fucking bargain. The Chitten Hotel in Keshan. So, if you're passing Keshan, find the Chitten Hotel. Hello?
Hello?
Ashkrapa? What is this? Hello? What is this? What are you doing? What, we've just been pissing ourselves? Who is it? Is it the receptionist or
Earplugs.
I'm pretty sure. I thought you were saying it's rude, you're being an ass. That's what it
was. That fucking idiot.
Across the hallway.
He's trying to sleep. So fucking when the receptionist comes in, he comes out of his room. Shoo, shoo, shoo. Earplugs. Fuck off.
Jersey to Asia. Winding up the Turks. Oh, right. Anyway. That'll do.
That'll do for the decrepit room, yeah.
Doesn't like you, mate. That neither did that dog yesterday. Made you jump, didn't it?
Push back, my mate Charlie. Push, push, push. Yeah, yeah.
Whack it, mate. So what's the crack, Knights? What's going on with your bike? Why is all your bags on the floor?
Came to a bike shop and asked if they sold an ears for the kids. We've seen some sturdy ones and some kids' bikes.
Yeah.
They're not willing to sell me that one.
No.
They're willing to sell me another wanky fucking
one arm thing.
One arm bullshit.
I was saying that mine's got one arm, so
yeah, but look how thick the metal is.
Yeah, but that could be solid as well, eh?
It's made out of chrome.
Chrome, yeah. Heat-treated chrome.
It's fucking hollow aluminium.
Yeah, well, I don't know, it might be sad. If you're saying it holds 40 key.
That it can hold 40 to 45 kilos.
We'll know. In the next half an hour, we will know.
One curb, mate, we're gone.
Well, that's it. We'll then just go off there with force. And if it fucks, just go, look.
I go to Thailand.
So he's on his third pannier now. So he did France, got to Italy, new pannier. Did Italy, broke again, but made it last to Turkey, just about, and now he's on his third one.
See, it started snapping in Greece, didn't it? So I've managed to get 500 miles out of the broken pannier. come out to the point where I can pick the top off again.
Just three things, just balancing on it.
It's held together in a tube, duct tape, and an old chain.
Sounds good, mate.
So, I'm sitting on the pavement, on the coat while there, the engineers are at work.
10 of them.
20 lira, what's that?
£7.
Yeah.
So how much did he pay? How much was the Bond Trial? The Bond Trial one was 35 in Jersey. The one in Italy was 50 euros.
That's 35.
35 euros, and now it's 20 lira. So they're getting cheaper.
They're getting cheaper, yeah.
But they're also getting not as strong.
Flimsy, yeah.
Oh, great stuff. Anyway, yeah. So this is what we're doing at the moment, and then I'm gonna go and get all this chopped off after, or shaped. I might get some sort of Turkish design, you know, just like a little. Little devil beard or something like that, you know. But yeah, definitely. We'll see. Cool. So what's this place? What's this called? Enezi.
Yes.
Enezi.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Enezi.
Right. So we're outside Enezi in Keshan. Nightsy's yes. got his paneer fixed, or well, not fixed, but a new one. An industrial strength one, yeah, Nights.
Hello,
you mean? You know, all suited and booted. Is it Wiglin?
No, it's
pretty sturdy. It's good stuff, so yeah. And he got that for 25, and they've given us some Turkish stickers, which is well good, because that's what I wanted, because I wanted to get a bit of a collection on the go. You know, I've already got my Kashan one, and then now I've got my Turkey one, so yeah. So this is the shop here, Enezi. Enezi in Kashan, so if your bike breaks and you're in Kashan, come here. You know.
So my bike's fixed.
Yeah, yeah, all gone, all gone.
We've,
one blemish.
Well, Ryan wants a shave, so. Oh.
How much are you paying for this? 5 lira.
5 lira. So, not even 2 quid.
Well, that's all, it's 5 euros. And I said, no euros, lira. And it was 5 lira. But you can exercise your French in if you want, mate.
Bonjour.
Speak to that guy over there.
Do you
know me?
I don't mean
better than you.
Yes, never
forgot him. Chelsea. Chelsea. Chelsea, comrade.
Galatasaray?
17 Mayıs gibi.
I know Galatasaray.
Galatasaray, UEFA.
You know Manuel Adoui?
Copenhagen.
Yeah, yeah, that's the one. Nobody has a clue what anyone's saying.
17 Mayıs 2004'te Barcelona'ya kaybettiler Şampiyonlar Ligi.
Barcelona.
Onu hatırlamaları lazım. Bak ne Galatasaray formu gidiyor orada aslan.
Nasıl makasak saltı?
Makasak saltı gönderiyor. Arkaları da.
Not bad for style then.
En son sen oldun. Bayağı oldu.
All off mate.
All off.
All off. And that's me until I go to Middle
East. Nasıl yoklar başlamışsın?
Onlar sesine bir ay.
Hani en çok dünyada ekler, mekler, şeyler karşılıklı en çok Türkçe'de.
Bu arada unutma. Öyle kalsın. Kısa mı kestin sonra?
Kısa onun saçta.
Ha, şu an. Beni forlara diyorsun.
Side is gone, man.
Getting up close and personal with the HD, is it?
Right.
Biz buraya Ipsala'ya gidemiz ama. Yok kardeş. Melek katılıyoruz 6 sene oldu. Bu yüzden daha sonra şarkıları da gidiyoruz.
And he's wafted it. In my mouth. That's now 2 days in a row I've suffered a bit of pain. Chili dog thing yesterday, and then just slapping all that far, no doubt, on my face.
Now this is the kind of sting, right?
Nah, it's gone in, it's good.
Yeah.
Now pay me.
So what have we done today, Knights?
Sat around in the hotel room, went to get told to leave, which never happened. And then we went to the bike shop, got that from here. We went for a shave, baby face. And then the cycle to
Butchakoy,
which is the main town on the map. Turned out to be a rural little village with chickens running around, fires in the middle of the road. So there's no cash point there either. We thought, right, still haven't sent our visas off for India, so we thought we'll just go back to
Keshan
and pitch up in the opposite field to the one we were in when it was raining. So we're going to stay here tonight and then get the visas done tomorrow and then probably look for somewhere a bit more permanent in the next few days.
Yep, sounding. And on the shop in front, everything's a lot cheaper. Like, I don't know, milk, 120 Turkish lira, no, 120. 1 lira, 20, whatever it is, dakalios or something like that. And it works out about a third of, you know, is what it is in the pounds, so it's like 40p. I don't know, mate, I'm just losing the plot on the camera here now. I'm hungry, so my brain's not functioning properly. I'm talking about food and thinking about food. so anyways, cheaper, so I'm actually going to cook a different meal tonight from pasta, which will be a change for the last 30 days. So yeah, so I'm going to crack on with that. So maybe another edition of Campfire Cooking.
Alright,
Turkey edition. Alright, anyway, for now. So, welcome to another Campfire Cooking, Turkey edition. And tonight we have, believe it or not, there's 4 baked potatoes buried in that fiery mess there. And I'm going to make some sort of, some sauce that I'm going to scrape all my jacket into. And at the moment I've just got onions and green peppers. Now when I was in a shop earlier, I was looking in the fridge, and next to all the cheeses in that, I thought, right, sounds dairy crap and sliced cheese. And then I seen these 4 little things here, so I gave them a squeeze and I thought, you know what, that's just going to be local dairy. So I've just opened one up here, doesn't look the greatest, and had a little nibble, couldn't get rid of it in my mouth. It's like sticking to me like bloody gum. Look, just rolling it into a ball, and the fire out goes. And then I just did the translation of Yaz Hamamayaze, and it's actually yeast. So I've bought like 4 blocks worth of yeast. I don't know what I'm going to do with them. I don't think there's anything I can do with them. But so they can go in the bin, I think. And what are you cooking there, Sunshine?
Coffees for now, mate.
Nice, he's racking up the coffees to, because he had to try a bit of the yeast as well, so I don't think the taste was that.
It's not the best.
It's not the best, mate. Age of yeast is not the best. And, to add to that, a bit of tomato sauce, some salami, and then, like I said, when everything's done, scrape it out into there, maybe some Dijon, you know, just to top it off, and then that'll be a campfire cooking turkey edition. Quick follow on from the last video. Coffees are now in hand, and we're using, I don't know if you recognise this, Knights' old paneer rack to flame bake our, what was that? plain bake our potatoes. So yeah, campfire cooking, paneer edition.
Paneer edition. Yeah.
Mate, they're all over the place. Look, again. We're just lucky that that one was caught in a web. Yeah, random firefly caught in a spider's web and just got eaten by a spider. But there's little fireflies all over the place again. But you've seen them before, so I'm not gonna bother showing you again. What's the plan for the day, mate?
Head to something.
Malkara.
I knew there was an I in there.
Yeah, so as Knight said, head to Al Qaeda. So yeah, we're going to Malkara. We're going to get those visas sent off today and laze around doing nothing really, I suppose, innit? See what the cafes have to offer, maybe. Get another kofte.
Koftis, yeah.
Koftis, mate. They're good, man. They're good. Yeah. 250 lira, so it's like 80p. So good, man. When we were in that Booker Choi yesterday, they were selling it again. And I went up to some woman. I said, nekada. She went, like, 3 lira. So I like, Sam, went to the guy cooking it. Nekada, 4 lira. I went, 2. And he went, no. I was like, right, we'll leave it in, because then I can get it cheaper elsewhere. So yeah, but you know, when you're travelling on a budget, you can't go, yeah, alright, then that'll do. You know, you have to get the price as low as you can or walk away from it. But yeah, the joys of our trip, innit?
Evet.
That's the Turkish way for yes. So we're learning a bit of Turkish. I'm doing a few words a day and then processing them into Knightsy's brain across the day, which is a bit of a challenge, isn't it, Knights? Come on, what's hello?
That's what I was trying to think, but... Hello.
Merhaba.
Merhaba. Is that it?
Merhaba. Merhaba.
Merhaba. The sheep is still there, though.
What's how much?
Ne vida?
No. Ne kara.
Ne kara.
You're closer to saying bye, then. Evida.
Evida.
Evida. And what's no? Yok.
Yok.
Getting there. You know, 4 days, 4 words. But anyway, we're going to get on the road, so yeah, for now. not you two, I swear, whatever. They're thinking the shit's going to get nicked from now, I know. Well, anyway, we're in, where are we? Malkara. Malkara, yeah, and it's bloody mental here. And it's hot, and trying to drag the fucking bikes around a little market like this. I mean, look, we've got these little followers here. Look, here they are. Look, all around here. These lot. So we're just stopping here for some koftis. And they reckon our bikes that are about 2 metres away from us are going to get robbed or pickpocketed. Like, but, I mean, we don't take our eyes off them after Italy anyway, so whatever, eh? Yeah. But interesting little place. What's the crack with the bike shops here then, mate?
Well, on the outset they look like bike shops, but when you actually take a closer look, they sell white goods. So I don't know whether to buy a washing machine, get a bike free, you know?
Yeah. Get a bike to carry it home on. Like.
There's no bike specific shops. There's no washing machine specific shops. They come as a whole. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Mental. There you go. Alright, so just been to the, where is it? There's a post office over there, and went in there. Postal, yep, put your stuff over here, weighs it, four lira, pass it to a guy who runs off and thinks, hold on, that's not right, I haven't filled out anything here. You know, they just run off with like 2 visa applications and 2 passports, like, you know. And then I go, whoa, and I was like, very important, yeah. I was like, right, and she went, okay, you know, she started filling out a tracking form, she's writing India all over it. I was like, not India. Keep trying, India. It's not India. Get on the translator. I was like, destination, not India. Calls this guy and blah, 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 blah. He's like, where are you from? It's like, oh, England. These need to go to London. Blah, blah, blah. Right, and that's that one sorted. Then the price went up to $6.75. So luckily, with the help of a translator, the fact that I wasn't sure when some guys just ran off with 200 quid's worth of passports in his hand, and the guy from the coffee shop, we've managed to get it sorted. So fingers crossed they arrive in London. If not, we could be, in what? How many days we've got left? 85 days we could be illegal immigrants. can't get out the island, can't get back in it, can't get anywhere. So we could end up in prison if this isn't sorted. But anyway, 90 days, watch this space. Right, so last night on the way to the lake, managed to pick up a puncture, no problem. Swapped them over the side of the road. Today, come back into town. Within 3 miles, the new one was flat. Don't ask me how, so I've pumped up like 2 or 3 times, came here, went to a couple of shops, got directed to this guy in here, and he's drilling out the other wheel now from the Italian job, and now I can fit straighteners all around, so I'm going to buy 2 inner tubes now, which will mean I'll put one in, I've got 2 spare straighteners, and I've got 2 sporty ones that can be fixed at some point, once I find a, something kitty, the repair kit, something kitty anyway. But yeah, so just a pain in the arse, these inner tubes, but it's good that I'm getting this done now, because with the roads being as they are here, I mean, you can see they're on the floor, like they're not the greatest, and then where we are, it's just all like, it's like they've just poured the tar and then put gravel on top of it, so it's not like flat, it's not steamrolled or anything like that. But I mean, if we're going into Iran and that's gonna be rocky roads, so I could end up stocking up another 2 or 4 before we leave. But yeah, anyway, that's what I'm doing. Yeah, cool.
So, just at the brow of this hill is the start of the downhill to the location where we are. And if I just give you a little shot, I mean, the weather's not amazing now, but I mean, it's nice and cool, so I'm not going to complain. But this is the lake, goodbye. Pretty sweet, eh? So yeah, but I've just done, well, probably it'll be another 5 miles before I'm there. But a 20-mile journey to get some inner tube sorted and some food, and I'm going to stop off here and get some water. There's random little... Like, imagine going to St. Juan's and just pulling down, I don't know, where the cannons are, for example. And then there's like, on walkways you get a standard tap anyway. But these guys go all out and get all these big marble structures just to feed like their sheep and goats and stuff. Talk about commitment, that's what it is. But anyway, well, I need my energy, so I'm going to concentrate on this. I'll show you that little thing in a sec. So here we go, random water feature in the middle of nowhere. Some effort and money gone into that. Yeah, just put a really expensive thing in for the sheep and the goats and that. Oh, fair play to them anyway. Onwards. So what was our little chilled out lakeside, you know, heat spot in the sun, has now turned into a blustery mess. So we've had to do some reinforcing. So this is what we've done. We've attached the front of each other's tents along here, pointing. And then I've had to reinforce mine against this tree. So that's mine, up from that side, and then the bike. Down to these points here, which is being counterweighted by the solar shower, which is actually like really warm, but the thing is it's too cold to be asked to use it now. And then I've just got a little one in there, because before the whole tent was just like, folding in. Yours is having a little dance, mate. Mine's alright, but...
Hey, woo! Crazy stuff, mate.
mental.
And it's Italy, the beach part two.
Fuck, this is windy enough.
You reckon?
That's a fucking lake, for fuck's sake. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's not the sea. That's a lake. And it was only a few hours ago we were saying, looks really nice for kayaking out there. Nah, I think windsurfing would be pretty good now, like. Windsurfing. Anyway, for now. For now. Yeah, I can hear him. They just ran off. Right. We don't. We put the torch on, but we're not really sure what's going on. Right, they're moving over there now. Right, but we're squatted.
We're squatting right next to the fucking lake because we're getting shot at.
We're getting fucking shot at. Right, I was lying in my tent before and fucking gunfire went off. Something ricocheted and hit the tent. Another one went off. Nights ago, we're getting shot at. I was like, nah, we're not. Next minute, gets even closer. Something hits Nicey's tent. We're like, right, shit. So basically, dressed in whatever darkest stuff we can, and we're clutched down the bank where we can't be sure. And there's a car bombing it up and down the road.
Been there for about 10 minutes. It just keeps going up and down, up and down. Fucking place I don't have like forever.
Night vision and stuff like that. Well, anyway, to be continued. Alright, still here, still alive. And yeah, last night was a bit hostile, and that's two nights in a row, because the night before was somebody just parked up there playing really loud music at like 4 or 5 in the morning. It's like, why would you do that? So they obviously knew we were here, and they thought, oh, we'll play some music. It was either to piss us off or to get us to leave. So we stayed another night, which was last night, and as you've seen from the last video, we were shot at. We weren't directly shot at, the bullets weren't coming our way, but they were going either into the trees or on the ground next to us, which was knocking things onto the tent. So if you've got someone with a gun standing 20 metres away from you and you hear bang, and next minute your tent gets a shower of stuff, then that's a pretty strong hint to either do one or it's their way of having a prank. However, we were saying yesterday, one thing we've learned on this trip is to expect anything, and we were expecting maybe a third night, and seeing as the level of hostilities going up, you know, I don't really want to wake up in the morning with my porch set on fire or, you know, the bikes being slashed or something like that. So we're going to move on today. I think we're going to go to the other side of town where we originally came up from and pitch there, because there's no need to do 60 miles to the next place because we don't need to do it, you know. So I think, I think we'll do a couple of days in Malkara. We've forecast rain in a couple of days, so we want to obviously be in a decent place when that happens. And then I think, what's it called? Tekadag. And then we're going to move on to Tekadag, which is only like 50, 60 miles, but we could push it today, but there's no point pushing it being boiling just to get there and be stuck on somewhere to sleep and then find out that it's just as much of a pain in the arse to get into the town as it is here. So, that's the plan for today.
That's the plan, mate. Don't get shot.
Don't get shot and stay alive. That's the plan. Right, so following on from yesterday's inner tube issues, I'm actually on my fourth one in 40 hours. So I've got the puncture in the sports one, put another one in, went to the shop, well, didn't even get out of this little town, had another puncture, went to the shop, bought two new inner tubes, fitted one, came back, felt this morning, gone again. Searched my rim, and this is what I found. Little shard of glass just wedged in the tyre, piercing every inner tube that I've put in, so I now have four inner tubes in need of repair. Two good ones that are in the bike, and nothing really spare, so I've sort of gone back on myself, but the issue's now resolved. Killing bugs. But anyway, yeah, so I think it's nearly time to move out, but it's weird weather. It's sunny, it's warm, it's windy, and it's raining. All in one go. Mad weather.
Tractor in the field.
I know, mate. Another one. The sheep.
Only in remote Turkey.
Isn't it?
Shotguns weren't enough, they're gonna run us over, mate.
With their tractors.
Tractors.
Recording. Yeah, it is, yeah. So we're just coming up the hill then, and a car stopped me and started chatting away, and I was just like, I don't know what you're talking about, and he's going like this. I was like, I don't understand. I thought he's definitely going to stop when he reaches Cooper, who's about 30 yards in front of me. Sure enough, stops. And I didn't hear what was said. Like, next thing I know, they're handing a fucking beer out the window to him. Like,
so he's going, and I was like, look, no smoke, no smoke. So I went like that, passed him my bottle like that, and he went like that. And then the other guy reaches over, passes that, and I went, all right, how much? And then he's going, guys going, no, 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 and they're saying no, and I was like, no. I was like, okay, sound, Tishakur, and then next minute the passenger starts going, Tishakur at the rim, opening the door. I'm thinking, like, what the fuck are you saying? Like, thank you like, very much. I'm like, shouting at him, and I'm like, I've already said Tishakur and all that. And he's fucking going to get out of the car, and his mate's pulling him back, and I'm like, you know, do I take this or what?
Yeah.
And his mate's going like that, and he's going, Tishakur at the rim, Tishakur at the rim. That's just like, what the fuck? Next minute he just pulls him and fucks off.
Mental. Random. So yeah, rural Turkey is definitely a new experience. It's just getting shot at last night, and then getting beers given to you out the window of cars and on the way back into town. So who knows?
And being shouted at.
And being shouted at. We've only gone, what, a mile?
Yeah.
2 miles, so we've got 8 to go. Who knows what the next state's got in store?
Old Knights, he's joining the mosque. No, he's not really, he's having an inquiry about the teaching rooms we've heard about. And it's basically just free accommodation. We think it's at a mosque anyway. It could be like their official buildings or something like that. But I thought if we try here, they can always say no or point in the right direction. They love it, right?
How many inner tubes is this now, mate? 4 and 48 hours.
Again, that's holding that problem.
Right, so we're on the outskirts of Malkara, and we thought we'd take like a track. Oh fucking hell, there's a big herd of cows coming up now. Thought we'd take a track anyway, and we spotted these trees and thought, you know, that'd be a nice little place to stay. Cotched up there for a bit, thinking that this Fiat might do one. Hello? Then all these fuckers started barking, and then old reinforcements ran. Oh, he's going away now. Reinforcements come up, and then now we've got a big herd of cows coming up. So, nice. They fuck off pretty quick, eh? There's another one up there, man. You're right. Is that what you were going, oh, about? All right. What's that thing I got? Pillock what? The fucking sausage. Start throwing them chunks of that. It's like masala pepperami. Right, anyway, look, no one's coming to see what these are barking at. Should we just walk in? I mean, if they go for us, they go for us. To be continued. All mouth and no action, man. They're just noise. Looks like we could be getting a field to stay in. But this one's guarding me now for a minute. Just a groaning noise. Where are these guys going? Oh shit, these lot are turning there. Alright, happy days. So the guy's going to let us stay in his orchard. And that's our little view. Pretty sweet, and there's wood to burn, so happy days. Gonna get pitched up and get a fire on the go.
Sorry? Any plans? No. Alright. Well, we were just going to stay here for one night. We were going to ask if it was okay if we built a fire.
Small fire.
A small. Yeah, we were just going to ask him if it was okay to build a small fire to cook our dinner, and then we'll probably leave at maybe midday tomorrow.
Or next week.
Yes, we were just going to sleep here tonight. But we were going to ask if it was okay to build a small fire to cook our dinner on. Just to cook our dinner, our food. Yeah, we have food, but we need to cook it. So we ask if it is okay to build a small fire to cook our food.
Sound as
sound.
Isn't it? Sounds like I joked about a bag of apples, like, and this guy's literally just left us alone. He's like, right, see you later, gone away. We started cooking like a crappy
pasta we've had every day for the last 2 months, right? Next minute, car backs up, reverse parts like, right, come over here, pick up this bench, put this bench down. Next minute, rolls out all these newspapers, sticks down free kofters, free beers and free yogurts. Sit down and enjoy. It's like happy days, man.
Our new favourite thing, isn't it? Kofties.
Kofters,
they're mate. Stunning, mate.
They are.
They are well nice, like.
It's like a little burger, isn't it? But it's, yeah. It's nice, it's herby burger meat and spices and a chilli. And then you basically just take a bite, and if it's too hot, you sip the yogurt. But so good.
Yeah, well nice, mate. Definitely beats pasta and lentils, doesn't it?
Same shit for the last 2 months, mate.
Same crap since Italy. So, yeah, we've got our effies.
Nah, I finished mine.
You finished yours?
Yeah, downed it.
Yeah. We'll get the fire going anyway and have a coffee.
Have a cofty, I wish. Yeah. Another cofter, mate. Another they are coft. Good, man.
Yeah, they're stunning, mate.
They range from, like, 2 lira up to, well, the most expensive one I've been offered was 4 and I turned it down, but 2 lira is, like, what, 70p?
70p,
and they fill you up, though, didn't they?
Oh, yeah.
They actually do the job.
Because you think it's a nice, decent bit of bread.
Yeah, and you get that, like, bread was stunning, mate.
You get, like, 5 or 6 of them little... They're like chicken nuggets, aren't they? But like beef.
Beef nuggets.
Beefy, like, you know, herby nuggets, yeah. They're just spot on, mate. Load of chilies.
Bang.
Hot sauce. But the can't
thing,
go wrong.
Thing is, after about 6 bites, the effect of the chili wears off. If you don't have the chili, then you're like, oh, this is bland.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. You've got to, like, we're going through like 2... We went through like 2 big chilies like that each.
Yeah. Yeah. When he put them down, I thought, that's just a shitload of chilies there. Then towards the end, when I'm looking, I'm like, right, I better put two on my plate just in case.
Mental, man. But yeah, so we've got a nice little orchard and some dogs to keep us company.
One nearly took my bloody hand off earlier, though. Killer.
Well, I thought they were gentle giants, mate, because when we came in, they were just barking and barking. As soon as I walked towards them, they were just all fucked off.
Look at it. Alright, anyway.
My phone's gonna die.
Start saying, Tishakur for watching.
Tishakur Edurin.
For watching.
I don't know what that is.
What are you doing there, Shaggy?
I'm going to feed my lentils.
Snot.
That I didn't.
Look at him, mate. He's well-keyed for it, look.
To the dog that nearly ate your hand before, yeah. So.
Yeah, he's being nice now, there's food about.
Hey, yeah, yeah,
yeah. Eat that shit. He's like, what the fuck's this? He's thinking, where's the food? Yeah.
Hold on. You eat that shit.
The foxy looking one's here now, look. Just find them pasta bits that fell on the floor and probably make a nice meal out of this one. Yeah, it likes that shit. Sitting here, eating dinner. And, clock some guy all in black. Underneath the pink house.
And, got a bloody gun in his hand.
It looked like you fucking pointed this way.
It's not easy doing this. I've got to say, it's not easy.
Crazy bastard.